What's up guys, Random Razor here with a random product review video for you guys today, and today we take a look at the DeWalt Booster Pack. So of course, without further ado, let's slice this open, check it out, test it out, and give you guys my quick in-depth review. So for those of you who are in the northern states or Canada here, the winters can play havoc on our batteries in our vehicles, and a jump starter, or a portable one like this, is certainly a must-have accessory for those of you winter drivers. Some of the primary features that they state on the box here is that this can start up to a V8 engine, has a built-in air compressor up to 120 PSI, a couple USB ports to charge your mobile devices, as well as a digital display to give you accurate readings. Alright, so popping this open, looks like we get some sort of charging cable. And the actual booster pack itself. Alright, so here's the booster pack itself, and as you guys see, it's not a very big thing to carry around. Nice large handle on the top, and pretty much an average size for a booster pack. So take a quick overview of this. You have large rubber guards on the top, the bottom, as well as the sides here to protect the pack itself. You have your positive and negative clips on the left and right side. So here is pretty much where you control everything. There's no actual on and off button. There's an on and off knob for the jumper part, but you don't actually need to turn this on in order to use the other features. For example, the built-in LED lights here, you just hit the light once to turn it on, hit it again to turn it off. Same thing with some other controls such as the air compressor here, as well as the USB. So if I hit the USB light, your USB ports are now on to charge your mobile devices. A bonus of this one here is that you do have a nice display here to give you accurate information on voltage, your battery status, and other things such as the air pressure, which you can use along with the air compressor, so you can see what the actual PSI is for your tires. And as I mentioned, if you want to use the jump start feature, all you have to do is turn this knob over. You're going to hear a nice long beep, and that's the one thing I don't like about this particular unit. The beep's actually quite loud and annoying for whatever button you press. And to turn it off, you just switch it the other way. Taking a look at the backside here, to charge the unit, you just pop this rubber cover off. You have two prongs here to plug an extension cable in, which unfortunately it's not included with this, but most people do have an extension cable at home. If not, they're only a few dollars. The other way to charge this unit is via the included car adapter here. So if you want to charge this in your vehicle, it's also an option as well. And speaking about the air compressor, here is your air compressor hose. And it's a pretty simple thing to work with. You just screw this onto your tire, hit the air button to turn it on, hit it again to turn it off. Whenever you reach your optimum PSI setting on your tires, which you can check via the digital display on the front of this unit. And as you guys saw earlier, there are built-in LED work lights, two of them actually. You just hit the light button. And as you guys can see, they fire up pretty easily. They're not the brightest thing in the world, but for example, if you want to change a tire to a spare tire in the middle of night and you're stuck on the road, having something like this is pretty useful, as it will light up the area where you're working. Alright, so that's a quick overview of the DeWalt Booster Pack here. Let's take it out to my old Buick and see if it'll jump the car. Alright, so here's a quick demonstration of the DeWalt Booster Pack here, and we're testing it out on a 1986 Buick Electra Park Avenue. It has a 3.8 liter V6 engine in here. Now this car has been sitting here for a number of years now. I'm pretty confident the battery is dead and there's barely any gas in the tank. So if we can get the engine just to turn over, then that should be enough to demonstrate that this battery pack here is more than enough to jumpstart a modern car. So we got the positive connected to the positive connector on the battery here, and the negative connected to the alternator to ground it. As I mentioned earlier, to turn on the jump start feature, just turn this knob here until you hear the beeping sound. And let's see if we have any life in this car. All right, so we do have lights, that's a good sign. All right, so let's see if there's enough juice in this battery pack to at least turn a dead car or dead battery and a engine that has been sitting for a number of years now. So anyways, that was a quick demo of the battery pack that's sitting well over there. And can't even see it. But anyways, yeah, there's enough power in that thing to turn over a dead car that's been sitting for a long time now. Dead battery, obviously it didn't start it because there's really no gas in the engine. But yeah, that should be more than enough for a modern day car. Most of the cases where people use these booster packs is that their battery is charged, but there's just not enough juice in it. So the fact that this turned over a dead battery should be more than enough. So that is the quick demonstration of the DeWalt booster pack here. Not the most ideal demonstration, but if it can turn over a 3.8 liter V6 engine in a 25 year old car, then surely this will be more than enough to start any modern day car, whether it's a sedan, crossover, SUV to a truck. Now, although this unit is functional and everything works, I'm not sure if I entirely recommend this product for a couple reasons. First off, there appears to be a manufacturing defect with the one I have here. As you guys can see, there's a bit of yellow plastic exposed, and it's actually because the front half of the enclosure and the back half don't seem to be lined up properly, so it's popping out. On the other side here, it's lined up perfectly, so it's kind of obvious that the other side isn't supposed to be like that. The second issue I noticed with my unit here is the connectors here. So this side looks like they're okay, but if you take a look on the other side, one of the rivets holding the top half and bottom half together is missing on the positive connector, whereas you can see it's okay on the black one. And I didn't go looking to see if this was actually broken. I noticed that the top half here actually came loose when I was disconnecting it from the battery earlier this video. So because I had not one but two issues with my DeWalt booster pack here already, it kind of leads me to believe, you know, how well will this thing last in the long run? Although everything works functionality-wise on this unit, it kind of makes me question the quality control for this particular product here. So in short, this is probably going to go back to Canadian Tire. I'm still not sure whether I'm going to exchange it for another one to give it another try or get a full refund. I'll probably give it another try since it's a pretty nice thing to have around. But nonetheless, for a company like DeWalt, which is supposed to be a premium end of tools and accessories, it's something I wouldn't expect from DeWalt with this particular battery booster pack. In conclusion, guys, I don't entirely recommend this product, particularly because I've had issues already out of the box with it. First off, with the exterior casing not being properly put together, and second, the connector is already starting to break with the rivets on the positive connection here that you guys saw earlier coming apart. That being said, the thing does work, and it works pretty nicely. The additional features that go along with the booster pack here is really a nice touch, such as the air compressor, work light, and all the other little things that go along with it. So if you do like what you see and you do want to give it a shot, most stores, you know, give you at least 14 days return policy. But I do recommend a bit of caution. So if you pick this up, maybe pull out all the box in your car before you actually drive it home and make sure everything is well put together and not falling apart like mine is already. But yeah, I don't entirely recommend it, but it's still a pretty nice unit functionality wise nonetheless. Anyways, thanks for watching, guys. Hope you enjoyed the video. And if you guys have any questions or comments about this, ask me in the comment section there down below. Hit that like button, as always, helps me out. And I'll see you all in the next video.